Así que, ¿a qué hora sales hoy, güey? ¿A qué hora te va a dejar de salir el gerente, cabrón?
No, tengo doble turno, güey. Se emputó porque pregunté dónde era la princesa tibetana y me dejó.
Y me puso más horas,
güey. Más horas.
Escuchando el altavoz del restaurante.
Que no sé. Entonces adentro sí que, ¿what?
¿Alguno de los comensales sabe?
¿Qué?
Ay,
pero estaba limpio, solo que estaba...
Miami es bonito. ¿Estás pensando dónde?
Estoy pensando eso.
Ah.
O sea, me estoy imaginando las dos. Pero me gusta mucho la idea de Los Ángeles. Miami ya, fijo ahí como 10, 11 años. Y también y sigo, porque voy y vengo, no fijo, pero... Entonces no sé si quiera regresar.
Pues prueba algo nuevo, como Los Ángeles.
Sí.
Se va a desaparecer si sigue haciendo cardio.
No, pues está hablando con la Sonia.
Sí, pero está caminando.
Sí, por eso, para hablar. Mm. Si corre ya no puede hablar.
Sí, no. No, si corre se desaparece, no manches. Está flaquito. Sí. Tiene que comer más. Perros.
¿Quién quedará mañana? De los dos. Los dos me caen muy bien. Pero yo no sé, creo que Cristian.
Va a quedar Cristóbal. Cristian. No sé. Y con lo que hizo ayer a Cristina, uff. Yo creo que la gente, si lo pusieron, se va a ganar el público. O sea, durmió con ella solo para cuidarla. Eso es muy lindo.
Sí. Y esta mañana también cuando... Ya estaba despierto, pero no me había levantado, ¿no? Y sentí que Cristina hizo algo como... Oh, nada más. Y Cristian brincó como un resorte, se sentó una...
Ah, qué lindo.
Entonces sí estuvo pendiente toda la noche y él casi no durmió.
Sí, no. ¿Está durmiendo ahorita?
No, ahí está ya.
Ya no tengo casi morado.
¿Ya no?
No.
Está bien, qué bueno.
Está bajando.
No sigas coleccionando.
¿Qué?
No sigas coleccionando morados. No tengo el pez más.
Ya sé. Pero te juro que es sin querer.
No, me imagino, ¿no? Creo que alguien quiera...
No, bueno, quiero ser me entiendes. Aquí. sea...
Me falta otro aquí para emparejarlo. Pa.
A ver, pues. Ayer me hice esto.
¿Tampoco sabes con qué?
No. Y aquí también, ¿viste? No me doy cuenta de los golpes.
Ayer no lastimé a nadie, bailando, nada. Nadie cayó al piso. No le torcí el pollo a nadie. Bueno, creo que sepa.
No. No. Estuviste muy divertido. Estuviste muy divertido.
Sí, me divertí ayer.
Qué sí. Bueno que saliste de la cama.
Sí, qué bueno que fuiste.
Sí, estuvo divertido.
Y lo que falta, ahí cuando estaba bailando con la corriente. Cuando me puse a bailar ahí.
Ajá.
Cuando agarré la correa así, te iba a agarrar así un pedo de fe. Pero bueno, no hubiera pasado nada tampoco.
No entiendo.
El baile, se te iba a bailar la silla y todo.
Y ah, ¿sí?
Con la correa, como la tenía ahí, pum, traer. Pero no sé qué pude haber hecho entonces, nada. ¿Qué podía haber hecho?
Pero estaba súper bien, no estabas
pedo. Sí, exacto, está bien.
No estabas, estabas happy.
Pero...
Pero no happy de trago, happy de...
Sí, exacto.
Como tú eres.
Nada de trago, no tomé casi nada.
No manches, no tomaste casi nada. 6 cervezas, no es nada. ¿Para ti no? No, a mí me dan 6 cervezas y olvídalo.
Una copa nada más de tequila. De vino, ¿cuánto fue? Antes de acostarme y después otra que quedó ahí.
Antes de acostarte vino también.
Sí, no, antes de acostarme.
Antes. Que lo tomaste como Coca-Cola. Ya, estuvo divertido. La música estaba buena, ¿no?
Sí.
Thank you. Deberían hacer eso como 2 veces a la semana, ¿no?
Nah, sí.
Yo los voy a adoptar a todos a mi casa.
¿Te late?
Y se pone una y luego otra.
Es que esta siento que suelta el plástico cuando lo rehusas, cuando no es plástico reusable. Tira este.
Sí, me lo va a fumar.
¿Está bien?
Sí.
¿Eh?
¿O lo quieres en el
tatuaje? Está en la cama de la sábana de té y la cura de las almohadas. Es el hombre que la cubica. Pero está ahorita que termina la sábana de la lavadora de la cubica. ¿Cómo? Con la lavadora de las sábanas.
Corriendo.
¿Y qué vas a acosarte?
No voy a
entrar.
Déjamelo.
Ah, ¿vas a ir para allá?
Me voy a lavar los dientes.
¿Motivo?
Pues ya no debería, ¿no? Ya no debería.
¿Por qué no? Ese es un... tropiezo.
Lo meto ahí. De hecho, prefiero que barrer.
Claro que sí.
wall of the Pool of Siloam near the King's Garden, and he rebuilt the wall as far as the stairs that descend from the City of David. Next to him was Nehemiah, son of Azduk, the leader of half of the district of Bethsur. He rebuilt the wall from place across the tombs of David's family as far as the water reservoir and the house of the warriors. Next to him, repairs were made by a group of Levites working under the supervision of Rehum, son of Bani. Then came Hashabiah, the leader...
Gisela.
Señora.
Tu micrófono.
Perdóname.
Qué bonito inglés.
Then came Hashabiah, the leader of half of the district of Keilah. He supervised the building of the wall on behalf of his own district. Next down the line were his countrymen led by Binui, son of Henehad, the leader of the other half of the district of Keilah. Next to them, Eser, son of Jeshua, the leader of Mizpah, repaired another section of wall across from the ascent to the armor near the angle of the wall.
Esas murallas todavía existen.
Yeah. Next to him was Baruch, son of Savai, who zealously repaired an additional section from the angle of to the door of the house of Eliashib, the high priest. Meremoth, son of Uriah, and grandson of Hakos, rebuilt another section of the wall extending from the door of Eliashib's house to the end of the house. The next repairs were made by the priest from the surrounding La Luz Blanca Metumba region. After them, Benjamin and Hashub repaired a section across from their house, and Azariah, son of Maaseiah, and grandson of Ananiah repaired a section across from his house. Next was Binui, son of Henadad, who rebuilt another section of the wall from Azariah's house to the angle and the corner. Palal, son of Uzziah, carried on the work from a point opposite the angle and the tower that projects up from the king's upper house besides the court of the guard. Next to him were Pedaiah, son of Parush, with the temple servants living on the hill of Ophel, who repaired the wall as far as a point across from the water gate to the east and the projecting tower. Then came the people of Tekoa, who repaired another section across from the great projecting tower and over the wall of Ophel. Above the horse gate, the priest repaired the wall. Each one repaired a section immediately across from his own house. Next, Zadok, son of Immer, also rebuilt the wall across from his own house, and beyond him was Semaiah, son of Shechaniah, the gatekeeper of the east gate. Next, Hananiah, son of Shelmiah, and Hanun, the sixth of the Salaf, repaired another section, while Meshulam, son of Berechiah, rebuilt the wall across from where he lived. Malkiah, one of the goldsmiths, repaired a wall as far as the housing from the temple servants and merchants across from the inspection gate. Then he continued as far as upper room at the corner. The other goldsmiths and merchants repaired the wall from that corner to the ship gate wall. He flew... I'm doing something wrong. Sanballat was very angry when he learned that we were rebuilding the wall. He flew into a rage and mocked the Jews, saying in front of his friends and the Samaritan army officers, "What does this bunch of poor, feeble Jews think they're doing? Do they think they can build a wall in a single day by just offering a few sacrifices? Do they actually think they can make something of stones from a rubbish heap and charred ones at that?" Tobiah and the Ammonite, who was...
Tobiah?
Tobiah.
Where was this number?
Tobiah and the Ammonite, who was standing beside him, remarked, "That stone wall would collapse if even a fox walked along the top of it." Then I prayed, "Hear us, O God, from we are being mocked. May their scoffing fall back on their own heads, and may they themselves become captives, in a foreign land. Do not ignore their guilt. Do not blot out their sins, for they have provoked you to anger here in front of the builders. At last the wall was completed to have its height around the entire city, from the people had worked with enthusiasm. But then Sambalat and Tobiah and the Arabs, Ammonites and Ashdodites heard that the work was going ahead and that the gaps in the wall of Jerusalem were being repaired. They were furious. They all made plans to come and fight against Jerusalem and throw us into confusion. But we prayed to our God and guarded the city day and night to protect ourselves. Then the people of Judah began to complain. The workers are getting tired, and there is so much rubble to be moved. We will never be able to rebuild the wall by ourselves. Meanwhile, our enemies were saying, before they know what's happening, we will swoop down on them and kill them and end their work. The Jews who lived near the enemy came and told us again and again, they will come from all directions and attack us. So I placed our armed guards behind the lowest parts of the wall in the exposed areas. I stationed the people to stand guard by families armed with swords, spears, and bows. Then, as I looked over the situation, I called together the nobles and the rest of the people and said to them, don't be afraid of the enemy. Remember the Lord who is great and glorious, and fight for your brothers, your sons, your daughters, your wives, and your homes. When our enemies heard that we knew on their plans and that God had frustrated them, we all returned to our work on the wall. But from then on, only half my men worked, while the other half stood guard with spears, shields, bows, and coats of mail. The leaders stationed themselves behind the people of Judah who were building the wall. The laborers carried on their work with one hand supporting their load and another hand holding a weapon. All the builders had a sword, the builder. All the builders had a sword belted to their side. The trumpeter stayed with me to sound the alarm. Then I explained to the nobles and officials and all the people, the work is very spread out, and we are widely separated from each other along the wall. When you hear the blast of the trumpet, rush to wherever it is sounding. Then our God will fight for us.
It's okay.
We worked early and late from sunrise to sunset, and half the men were always on guard.